My preferred margin is... It's easy to visualize when scanning and easy to mark the margin for design. To do the buildup, I use 37% phosphoric acid etch for 15 seconds on the enamel and dentin. Then, rinse with water for 20 seconds. Air dry thoroughly for 5 seconds. Adhesive bonding agent by 3M Scotch Bond Universal is scrubbed in for 20 seconds and then air dried to a thin layer. Next, light cure for 20 seconds. I use Ticor from EDS, which is a reinforced composite core material that preps like dentin and resists stitching. I place it in layers and light cure until the core structure is created. I re-prepare the tooth with a deep chamfer margin. When neighboring teeth have overhanging restorations or will become a problem for my final crown's path of insertion, I always smooth and shape these neighboring teeth. I find my crown delivery day is more predictable and it prevents future food traps around my dental work. My preferred margin is the chamfer. It's easy to visualize when scanning and easy to mark the margin for design. Tooth plane reduction is done by using a football diamond burr. Make sure to check occlusal reduction of at least 1.5 millimeters by using flex tabs by Kerr. I refine the prep with fine diamond burrs and soften sharp prep line angles using a Venus Super Flame pre-polishing point by Kultzer. A second larger hemodent-soaked retraction cord number 2 is gently placed over the first cord for lateral tissue displacement. This is known as the two-cord technique. Compracap by Colteen is placed over the prep to create pressure onto the gingival tissue near the margin for at least 5 minutes, no more, no less. The second cord is gently removed and the tooth is dried prior to taking an impression. I click design with my mouse for computer automated design generated again by artificial intelligence.